minutes, I want to thank Senator Ortiz, Alianza Indigenas Sin Fronteras, and Otom and Yaqui peoples. So let's get going. Borderlands. Welcome to the Borderlands, where Day of the Dead and Halloween walk hand in hand. Come out to the West Texas town of El Paso. Make yourself at home. Mi casa su casa takes on a different tone when someone else from out of town owns the house's banknote. Come to buy old El Paso. Come stand close and see the shanty towns that dot the sides of the mighty Rio Grande. Is that Mexico, everyone asks? Why, no. Our shanties are 100% American made, from sea to aluminum siding. Come on by and cross an arbitrary man-made line, imposed and encased in concrete skin. The tortilla curtain people have quipped, but flatbread isn't watched by helicopters whirling overhead. And while you're here making do as you please, visit our sister city across Tortilla Soup Way. Join the thousands from the south who've come with television dreams, holding clay ladles and empty bowls. Come and watch Madame El Paso pimp her older sister Juarez as she wears her made in the USA but assembled in Mexico dress in a Wild Wild West show, and hear the hollers of blonde cowboys as they pry her legs apart for free trade. Come and watch her take it all at the world-renowned donkey show, the one each tourist asks the cab driver to see. Or better still, jump in on the latest trend as scalps get cheaper every year. Join the ricos, GIs, and politicos as they comb the streets for twilight girls who can't scream for help, even in Spanish, and whose ribbon braids now lie intertwined in trash and rubble, and nobody knows a fucking thing. Welcome to the Borderlands, where exploitation and femicide dance hand in hand. On the note of mercantilism, can you see? It was bright enough on that border city street to see the reflected gleams of wet, burnt copper bodies, newbies of mercantilism, floating down a current, once rabbit maw, now outlined in a grand cement ditch, earthen figures with soda pop packaging rings, hollowing, gaping, gurgles, while magazine cutouts of mansions, brand new cars, blonde beauties remain clutched like rosaries. It was bright enough to see a lone figure stealthy from door to door, plying what he just stole, offering the best prices on side-out commodities to the neighbors or the window screens he just tore. It was bright enough to see sunburnt boys in spray paint ecstasy, seeking an escape tomorrow, enchained by notions of successful families and abbreviated destinies, while mucus streaks down, dry down their eyes. It was bright enough to see stocky papa and round mama as she holds baby in swaddling cloth, singing in an aboriginal tongue as he goes to find the work that the gringo, mestizo, ladino won't do, like swabbing down parking lots covered in regurgitated bile. Dollar-flinging children are spotted as she weeps to see his cascading slouch bent further still by short-handled brushes, all for their survival. It was bright enough to see on Mesa Street to see people thrashing celluloidal dreams, a man trading beads of calm with each VCR he discovers, bruised boys half-lidded in languid throes, and Papa groaning Spanish in phonetic tones. It was bright enough to see. It was bright enough. It was bright enough. It was clear enough. Oh, say, can you? But they all look like me. So what's the matter with Chihuahua? Potato skin, red skin, skin gins. What's the matter with the tomahawk chop? Nothing if you lack melanin, but if you're one of the peoples, then it's cowboys and Indians all over again. And just like in John Wayne movies, the ones with pigmentation are on the losing end. So what's the matter with Chihuahua? I ain't anybody's mascot. Take your Braves and Redskins and Chihuahua and shove them up your wazoo. As for me, I'm going out and forming the Apache Abbots. We'll get some native guys in long skirts going around smacking people on the noggin with bullshit Bible thumping, or the Uncle Sams who help overthrow legitimate democracies with their coaching staff of CIA and military advising teams in exchange for paper green, and then we can all do the spots better banana, thumping upon bare left chest with open right hand, por mia culpa, at the end raised
Down facing palms, an open salute to the old red, white, and blue, with an old sea Kyle and a smile. Or do the Uncle Sam, accounting scam, and built billions of greens from political machines and stupid ordinary Joes by forming Chief Wahoo Savings and Loan. Sorry, man. Trying to get funnier. Tommy Hawk. Since I like Tommy Hawks, apparently. I just saw an Indian mascot on TV. He was parading on a horse wearing mascara for war paint and a bad braided wig that kept slipping off to the side. He was making grimaces to the camera, carrying it on and looping it up. The next time that I see one, I'm going to kick the shit out of him. I'll wipe the war paint off his face and smear it on his ass like a target for a well-placed foot. And then I'll give him the Tommy Hawk right chop and do a little dance. Maybe the moonwalk. And when they arrest me, I'll say, he's not a real person, he's a group of people. In fact, I was honoring him by making sure his scalp was real. Oh, checking mine. One last one. My country. My country tis of thee. Because he took it from us. Sweet land of liberty, your pale as driven snow, of thee I sing with venomous contempt. Land where my fathers died, massacred by yours. Land of the pilgrim's pride, who would not survive without my mother's. From every mountainside, which has been fenced off by you, let freedom ring. Yes, let freedom ring, but not just from hollow throats and hollow souls, and return to us that which was ours, since the land drew her first breath and sang, this country, 'tis of me. Yeah.